So what's good YouTube, back here again with another video. Today's video is really just a celebration video on my 1 year of shooting film. I've been shooting film now for only a year. It's been a great year though. I have definitely shot over 1,000 images of just medium format. I do have some 35 rolls, but I don't necessarily like my 35 camera. But anyway, this video will be mainly about shooting with my new medium format camera. I recently picked up the Mamiya 7 II, which was a super exciting pickup. It's something I've been wanting for the last couple of months. And so I went out, I shot some Portra 160 in particular, and I'm going to give a review on that along with a small review on the Mamiya 7 II and things of that nature at the end of this video. But if you haven't already subscribed to this channel, this is Road to 1,000 subscribers. We're close, we're about 200 subscribers away. And I hope to keep putting out videos more often. But I'm not going to press myself to do that because I just don't know what my schedule's like. But anyway, let's get into this video. If you like it, please give it a like. Leave a comment down below on some things that you might want in the future. But let's get into this video. Alright, so I hope you guys like this video. I'm just briefly going to talk about my experience with my Mamiya 7.2 so far, and also my experience with Portra 160. So with my Mamiya 7.2, I really like it a lot. I like the point and shoot ability of it, but you still get the 6x7 frame. I think that's something that a lot of people that I've watched have said, which I totally agree. One thing I don't necessarily like is the rangefinder, which I'm still getting used to, and I think it definitely takes time to get used to it, just based on the focusing and all of that other stuff. But overall, I really like this camera. I like the quality of it. I'm still learning like the workflow of it, and you know, how to load properly and more fast. But overall, I would really highly recommend this camera. I used the 80 millimeter for the camera, so it's about the 40 millimeter equivalent on 35. So it's a pretty normal lens, which I also like because it's not too far away and it's not too close. So going into Portra 160, I realized a lot about this film, especially this day, because I got a chance to really go in, overexpose, underexpose, and be right at exposure. And one thing that I noticed when you overexpose the image, the blues in the image tend to go till when it comes to the blues. And you know, you can fix that in post. However, if it is too far and there's no information in the sky, it's going to be hard to really match that to a true tone blue or the blue that you saw the day of. But overall, I really like the look of just Portra in general. Portra 160, Portra 400, Portra 800. I think they're all great film stocks. They all have kind of a look already baked into the film, but you still have a lot of versatility to it. And I know a lot of you guys were telling me to try Pro 400H. And also, I think it was Fuji Color 100. And I tried Pro 400H. I haven't found any Fuji Color 100 at all. I think I looked over there, but it's totally fine. So I haven't oh my god, okay. So I know nah, it would be different there. I know a lot of you guys recommended in my last few videos that I tried Pro 400H, which I recently did get to go through a whole pack of Pro 400H. I think I went through 4 rolls out of 5, and I honestly don't like the film. There are perks of it. I think the dynamic range is great. The versatility you have in post is great. However, the grain structure of the film, not to sound like a snob or anything, but the grain structure of the film is very like grainy for my liking. I think I'm more of a clean look type of person, something with as less grain as possible. But I do think this film has its purposes. I think it would be great for like candid things, maybe out with your friends and stuff like that. I think it is definitely great for that because it has a more nostalgic feel. And I think it'll be great to look back on those things later on when you're doing things like that. But when it comes to portraiture, for me personally, I don't necessarily like it. I've had pictures taken of me on Pro 400H that I really like. However, I guess it's just like something you get used to. But yeah, that's really my take on just Portra 160. I don't want to make this video extremely long. But I really enjoy this process of, you know, going through different things. If you guys want more videos like this from me, just let me know. I don't know it all. I'm not a know-it-all. I just shoot and I kind of take in everything that I see on my end, and I try to explain it to you guys, and maybe you guys have the same problem, or maybe you guys have the same thoughts. So I just like to start a dialogue. If you like this video, give it a like. If you haven't already, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.